गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू?
यस आई एम सो फाइन। सो नाउ वी आर इन द एग्जामिनेशन वीक। ओके, सो वील नाउ रिवाइज द चैप्टर्स विच आर कमिंग द एग्जामिनेशन। ऑल चैप्टर्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड इन दिस एग्जामिनेशन द डिलीटेड पोर्शन मीन्स द रिवाइज पोर्शन दैट हैज बीन इंस्ट्रक्टेड बाई द CBSE, ओनली दैट पोर्सन इज कमिंग इन द एग्जामिनेशन एंड रिगार्डिंग दैट the portion has been sent to you also. On that basis, today we are going to revise today chapter 1, the real numbers. Okay, many things we have discussed. Okay, in this chapter many things we have discussed. Okay, and first of all, the main important thing in this chapter is the exponential formulas. Okay, what are those? Let's see this here one time. This is here the first rule. Okay, this A is called base and this m or n whatever is given, that is called exponent or power. Okay, so if these situations are given, then what is the rule we have to apply? So first of all, for this rule, see, a to the power m into a to the power m, in the same base is there, powers will be added. And regarding this one example has been also given there. Okay, and if the on the same base only one base is there and that m to the power m into n is there, that means what? That means this mn will come outside and they will multiply like this. Example is given here. See, for every rule the examples has been given. See, a by b to the power n, that means it can be written as a to the power n to b to the power n, like this. See here, if a it has been divided with the different power, see, one is m, one is n, in that case on the same base powers will be subtracted. So these rules are there, examples are also given here. Okay, examples are also given here, so we have to remember these all exponential laws, and we have done also. Okay, now that it is now defined in the detail. Multiplication rule, the same rule that we have discussed in the previous slide, but they have been given one name there, and you can see that. Okay, you can just see. Oh yes, two things is new here. What is that? New things are here added. One is called zero exponent. If power is zero, then what is the answer? This is the answer. If negative exponent is there, then this is the rule. If fractional exponent is there, then this is the rule. So this all together, now this is the key of the laws of exponents. Okay, now the next topic, rationalizing the denominator. Yes, this is the very important topic here, and the examination you should practice in the whole class 9 or class 10 also. This type of things will mainly come, so it should be in your practice. Okay, what does it mean? It is saying that to rationalize the denominator means to eliminate any radical expression. Now what is radical expression? No need to explain, we have done lots of things on this. Even then, one more time you can say, this is called radical sign. Its power can be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that doesn't matter. But this is called radical sign. Okay, under root sign. Okay, so if that is here, then the key idea is to, where it has gone? Yes, it is moving also. The key idea of this is to multiply the original fraction by an appropriate value, and that value is called rationalization factors. That value is called rationalization factor, and this I will discuss in the next slide here. Okay, understand first thing here, we have to rationalize the denominator, that the denominator should be free from radicals. See here, last line, the denominator no longer contains radicals. It should not contain any this type of things there in the denominator only. Yes, numerator can contain there. Okay, we don't have to bother about that, but as far as denominator is concerned, we have to worry. It should be free from this type of things. Okay, now these are some rationalization factors. See this here. Let me explain this. These all terms can be in the denominator. Okay, though their rationalization factor means the factor which can make the denominator free from the radical. So these are the corresponding factors. You may see this one time, see nicely. Okay, and here is the result. These all are really only and only rational. They are free from the radical signs. See these radical signs here everywhere, and this will remain in the denominator. Now they are free as we have multiplied with the rationalization factors. Understood what is rationalization factor? Means those terms which can make our denominator free from the radical sign. Okay, and this RF will be multiplied. RF means rationalization factor will be multiplied, same number will be multiplied with the numerator as well as denominator, but the denominator will become free from the radical sign. Yes, in numerator it may come. Okay, that's not a problem there. Okay, so on that only I have made one video. I think you should watch that video. Okay, many things we have explained. Online classes, when you will come there, lots of things will be clear. Your most of the doubts will be clear in that online classes also. So don't miss these online classes of any teacher. Attendance is also very important. I hope you all are doing their classes there. But even then, when your teacher is not present and you face problem, that time these videos are very helpful. Okay, so we are going to make one, just going to make one video on this. I think you should see this. Okay, see here. We have to prove here something. What we have to prove? We have to prove that 1 plus 3 plus root 7 plus 1 by root 7 plus root 5 plus 1 by root 5 plus root 3 plus 1 by root 3 plus 1 is equal to 1. Okay, we have to prove this. Okay, now see one thing here. If you will observe it nicely, you will see that the all denominators containing radical, that means what? That means we have to use their RF, rationalization factor. Clear? So we have to use that. See how we can use this one. Here is that. First of all, we'll take them separately there. First of all, this 1 by 3 plus root 7 will be multiplied with this RF, and its RF is 3 minus root 7. Just now we have seen in that slide also. So 1 plus 3 plus root 7 into 3 minus root 7 divided by 3 minus root 7, and we know that the same number has to be multiplied with both numerator and denominator. So upside is 3 minus root 7, downside is a minus b into a plus b, that is a square minus b square. Okay, so on that basis, now it is 3 minus root 7 by 3 is a 9 minus 7, that is equal to 2. Now first term is clear. Now the second term will come. Okay, I am writing this in the corner so that I can remember it. This is a long lengthy calculation, so I may also face problems, so I am just writing it so that I cannot forget it. Okay, now the next term will come, and that is 1 by root 7 plus root 5. Again, one that denominator has come in the form of radical. Again, I need one rationalization factor, and that is root 7 minus root 5. No need to explain why it is so. Okay, upside is remain the same, only downside it will become a square minus b square. A minus b into a plus b is equal to a square minus b square. So this second term will become root 7 minus root 5 by 2. Again, I will write this in one corner so that I cannot forget these calculations here. Now two more terms are remaining here, isn't it? So two terms are remaining, so one by one they all will be rationalized here. So this root 5 plus root 3, its RF is root 5 minus root 3.
downside also root 5 minus root 3. So now this calculation will become root 5 minus root 3, and downside is a square minus b square. So root 5 square minus root 3 square. Okay, so that is root 5 minus root 3 by 2. Root 5 minus root 3 by 2. Okay. Now what? Now the last term is remaining. That is also containing radical sign. You may see that. This one is also containing radical sign. So in that case, it will be also, see, we are rationalizing this. This root 3 plus 1, this is its RF here. So now it is going to be rationalized here. Okay. So now, same formula, same rules for all each and every term there. So now this will become root 3 minus 1 by a square minus b square, that is 3 minus 1. So it is root 3 minus 1 by 2. Now all these terms will be kept together so that it can be easily calculated. So I will erase the board and then all these terms will come together here. Okay. And then we will get our final result here. How easily it can be solved? Only we have to keep patience. We don't have to worry about the length of the question. Let it be. No problem. Sir, we can solve. That should be the spirit there. Okay, now. So all the terms and their rationalized terms. Rationalized means they are free from the, denoted is free from the radical sign. So they, I have written all this here. Now one term is remaining, that is 1 by root 3 plus 1. It is also root 3 minus 1 by 2. Okay, this is our LHS part. Okay, by calculating LHS, we will get RHS value. LCM is 2. LCM is 2. So upside it will be written as 3 minus root 7 plus root 7 minus root 5 plus root 5 minus root 3 plus root 3 minus 1. Plus root 3 minus 1. Okay, now what? Same terms will be cancelled. Okay, same terms here, see, this is minus root 7 and this is plus root 7, cancel. This is minus root 5 plus root 5, cancel. This is minus root 3 plus root 3, cancel. So they all will be just cancelled only. Okay, so now after that, 2 by 2, see, by using this, we have found our result by using that LHS only. So this is how we can do the rationalization of the terms there. Okay, in the next class we learn something new. Till then, all of you, be studious, read nicely, be at home, remain safe, and then give the examinations very well. Okay, all the best for your examinations. Okay, thank you class. In the next class, we learn something new. Till then, all of you, take care. Thank you class. Thank you very much.